Good. Good. Okay. Candy's later. I have a question for you this morning. Tell me about who's the strongest person you know. Real person, not superheroes. Real person. Who's the strongest person you know? Okay, God. Jesus. Okay, let's put it down on the earth. Somebody you know. A person you know on the earth. Somebody you know. A person. Who do you think is the strongest? Somebody at your school? Who do you think is the strongest person at your school?
You don't know?
Nobody? Okay. What about you, Trishon? Do you know somebody who's really strong? Another kid, a big brother, or sister, a cousin? Anybody you saw is really strong? No. When I was growing up, there was a boy in my neighborhood. His name was Lewis, and he was older than me, and he was really strong. Well, he threw me, actually. We used to play like monsters, like Godzilla, and he'd pretend like he was the superhero, and he'd pick me up and throw me across the yard. Sometimes. So anyway, he was really strong, right? So sometimes, he was really strong, and so sometimes we know people who are really strong. Well, I want to talk about somebody who's strong, and you can look up here at the screen. You can look at the screen. This boy's name is Maddie Stefanik. Now, you might not think he's strong. He doesn't look very strong, right? He's in a wheelchair, you'll see. He was really sick, boy, and he died, unfortunately, when he was only 13 years old. So you would think he's not very strong, right? But Maddie was a really strong boy. He did lots of things that ordinary kids like to do. Even though he was in a wheelchair, he liked to play, liked to draw, and he really liked to write. And can you believe, even though he died when he was 13 years old, see all those books, he wrote all those books. He wrote books of poetry called Heart Songs, and they became really famous, and some people even wrote songs from the poetry that he wrote. And everywhere he went, he used to talk to people about being good. He talks about the importance of living a gentle life and caring for other people. And he said what was most important to him was praying and playing and celebrating life every day in some way. So even we think, you know, big muscles, that means someone who's strong, or like a superhero is strong. But the Bible tells us that God's weakness is even stronger than human strength. And even someone like Maddie, even though he looks weak, God made him really strong and really wise. And many people's lives have been changed by Maddie and what he did and all the poetry that he wrote. And so even though sometimes we might feel we're weak and powerless, we all have the opportunity to live and celebrate with God and God's strength. We can make a choice. Oh, that's right. A lot of people think you're weak at your school, but actually you're not weak. You're very strong. That's true. You guys are very strong, too. And so I want to pray for you and thank God for Maddie and thank God for making us even strong when we feel weak. Let's pray. Gracious God, we thank you for people like Maddie who did such amazing things with what you gave them, using the gifts and the abilities and the strengths that you gave them. And we just pray for your children. I pray for Justine and Trayshawn and all the kids that they know, Lord, that you would give them your strength so that even when other people think they're weak, you would give them wisdom and intelligence and the abilities to do amazing things. And we pray that you would always be with us and strengthen us in our own weaknesses, whatever they may be. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.